Get ready for some NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. And here at the midway point of the season, the perfect time to check out the rookie rankings. Who will be the NBA Rookie of the Year? Some great young players. He's been a big-time contributor for his team so far, and you know, we're right in the thick of the season, and he's one back of the top spot.
And with more or less a half a season behind us, he has shown what unlimited potential he has.
And wasting no time tapping into it. He's number two right now, but he has a shot at being number one if he can string together some big performances.
Now the starting group for the visitors and for the Huskies. And as we're into the middle of the season now, GA, how much of a rhythm are teams in for their day-to-day activities?
I mean, most teams should have found their flow by now, and they know their rotations and guys are in the groove of the season. I mean, that's not the case for every team, unfortunately.
Now Smith. Driving in. Huskies with the rebound. And so it's the Huskies with it. Out left to the wing. It's stolen. Morton guarded by Stewart. Over to the wing. Six on the shot clock. Inside. The shot goes in. First shot, first basket.
And the fireworks begin. Should be an amazing show tonight.
How good is it to see the first one go through the net?
And about a minute gone here in the first quarter. And there's the pass to Newton. To the paint. It's tipped. Smith scanning the floor. Guarded by Stewart. Up and in on the layup.
Yeah, going hard to the rack, making a statement here early on.
Well, this is his game. Be proactive offensively. Put the defense back on his heels.
Fires for three. Hits it from three-point range.
And that's exactly what he's looking for, draining the triple.
We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Out to Smith. Fires the three. He's now one for two with that bucket.
Matching baskets from the perimeter, an earmark of today's game.
Hey, players love competition, and the fans love it as well.
And it's blocked. What a play as he just snatches the shot out of midair. Down low. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed.
I mean, beautiful execution of the game plan offensively. So far, they are hitting 80% from the field.
We're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. Banked in off the glass. He's got five.
And I like to see this. They're calling his number early, and he's delivering.
It makes sense, right? You're trying to get off to a fast start, and he can help with that.
Pulls it up. With nobody on him, he buries the jumper.
And the story here, Kevin, early on, is how well they've shot the basketball.
And here in the first quarter, with a little over 3.5 minutes played, pass to Karaman. To the left side wing. They set the pick. A floater, and it goes down 2 points.
You just love how reliable he is night in and night out. His offense is there.
Here's Morton. Drops in the tray.
That's a shot the defense looked like it was willing to give up. Big mistake.
The Huskies have gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. From 11 feet away, and he drops that one in. Gotten 6 of 7 shots to fall in the first quarter. They're off and running. For three, his second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Yeah, and that's back-to-back threes. The D just seems to be slacking off a little bit.
Newton passes to Carlemon. Lets it go with a three. And the Huskies hit again from deep.
They're still behind, but not because of his efforts. He's been unbelievable this quarter.
Smith on the wing. 5 to shoot. There's the pick. Tries it from 19. That shot, no good.
You expect him to make that, especially from that distance.
Newton, covered by Smith. Shoots. No good from the wing.
Yeah, he's kicking himself. No defenders to be found in that mid-range area.
Shoots the three. Huskies with the rebound.
And that was a game to forget. You'd like to find some teachable moments, but I think they'd like to just turn the page and move forward.
Nothing wrong with that. Sometimes we overanalyze things. Can't be better to just let it go. Trying to slice into this deficit every time up the floor. Terrific quarter for him.
Gotten 7 of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Time excellent time pace out to their offense. Start.
So both teams changing it up here. And the Eastern Conference has been fun to watch. A lot of focus as always this year. And as we hit the midseason surge, let's check out the standings and how they're shaping up. You look at the Huskies, this hasn't been the kind of year they envision. Time running out.
And you know, for the Huskies, they have been one of the major surprises in the NBA this season. Unfortunately, for the wrong reasons.
What a nightmare of a season it's been for them. Nothing has gone right for a team we all thought would be real contenders coming into the year.
Here now, the 2K leaderboard, showing us the best passing teams in the NBA over the course of the last month.
And what stands out during this recent stretch is just how well they passed the basketball. I mean, this is a club that has become really unselfish.
The Huskies making a switch here. Johnson's checked in. 1:32 left to play in the first quarter. The shot goes in. First shot, first basket.
Now that's a high percentage look when the D doesn't fight over the screen.
Reason why, it takes extra energy to do it. You have to trust your defensive rotations, but it's worth it.
And they pick up two.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
The Huskies have gotten 7 of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Excellent pace to their offense. Passes to Spencer. From downtown, and the Huskies hit again from deep.
Boy, both teams racking up the points to start this game.
And you wonder how long they can keep it going. At some point, you expect the defense will adjust.
Gone 8 of 11 in the first quarter. They'll take that percentage any night. There's a screen. There's 47 seconds left in the first quarter. Back to Jones. Over to the left wing. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back. 10 points for him.
Defensively, they've had no answer for him this period, and he continues to stay aggressive.
The pass to Spencer. From past the arc, connects from 3-point range.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working.
How often do we see this these days? Clubs answering each other from range.
About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Back to Smith. Here's the screen. Puts up a three. The shot comes out. Tie game and some big points being put up on the board, Clark, as we wrap up the first. Let's take a quick break now, and then it's on to the second quarter after this. And close game underway so far. We'll see if either of these teams can jump out in the second quarter. And what do you guys think about the Huskies here in this one?
Showing a lot of confidence in their rotation. They went right to that bench when they needed points.
This is where you credit the guys in the front office for going out and getting you the pieces you need.
Outside ball. Shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
Oh, that's some fancy ball handling right there. Since when does he take guys off the dribble?
Jones in the post. The shot goes in. First shot, first basket.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
And for the Huskies, pass to Ross to the inside. Takes a shot at the elbow. Being 71% all in all in this one, they've been brilliant offensively. Pass to Jones. Steve, there's a whole lot of young talent throughout the NBA, but which players to you stand out above the rest?
Kevin, there's the obvious ones like Luka Doncic, Jason Tatum, SGA, Ja Morant, and Anthony Edwards. They are consistently growing as players. I am keeping my eye on a guy like Evan Mobley. He could be an all-time great defender.
Shot clock at 6 to the middle.
Way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
Husky shooting their first shots from the stripe in this game.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific, 79% as a team.
And that one misses. So he comes up empty at the line. From outside the arc, good on the triple. He has five.
Woo! He got a clean look, and he makes the defense pay for disrespecting him.
There's a good screen. Passes it to Spencer. And he banks in the layup.
Great job executing the offense. That pass on time and on point.
Gone 2 of 3 from the field here to open the second quarter. Outside, Jones. Takes it inside. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2. Just phenomenal here tonight. 73% from the field. We're just over 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. Can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper. Six to shoot. Intercepted. And now Ball pushing it up. No one back to stop him. And the jam by Ross.
Gotta take care of the ball. They'll punish you if you're that careless.
That's right, and that's severe punishment right there.
We talk about it time and time again. Turnovers are costly, especially when the game is close.
And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play. Now here's Jones. Tight defense on him. To the inside. Huskies with the rebound. Saves off to Brooklyn after this game as they have the Nets to look forward to. Hit the road with that, the first of a 5-game run.
And you can see him give a little nod and then just burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
A pair of teammates, Greg, with a terrific feel for each other. Gone 3 of their first 5 shots to drop here in the second quarter. Knocked loose. Outside, Ball. Unloads from 13. Green for 2 points. 6 points for him.
Oh, great production on the interior right now. 8 straight from inside. Let's see if coach can get them back on the right track.
Because right now it feels like the pace is being dictated to them. They need to go back to playing their brand of basketball.
chance now to check out how the All-Star voting is shaping up.
And I tell you, the excitement starting to ratchet up a little bit as the tallies start coming in.
He's currently atop in the Eastern Conference. He's got a lot of fans the world over.
He's got plenty of fans among his fellow players as well. I'm sure he'd be number one on their ballots if they were voting.
A great All-Star weekend it'll be. We'll keep you updated as we get closer. Let's it go from 14. Good on the shot.
And likes the view from there. He's a strong mid-range shooter.
And with that height, he can get a clean look on any shot at any time.
The pass to Stewart. They set the pick. Lock at six. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
It's so hard to keep the defense honest when you miss wide open looks like that.
And the D getting outworked there on the putback. Can't let that happen.
For some reason, blocking out has become a lost art, and that's the result you'll get.
Here's Morton. Out to Smith. Fires the three. Does not score again. That's his fourth miss against one make. Wing shot on the way. He can't get it to go. Gone 4 of 8 so far here in the second quarter. They set the pick. Out to the wing. Let's go. Huskies with the rebound. The Huskies making a switch here. Ross is checked in. The Huskies leading by 3. Newton covered by Smith to the left wing. Pass to Newton. Here's Karaman. Hands it from downtown.
Yeah, clearly a defensive lapse there. He is automatic from deep if you're going to leave him that wide open. Big time mistake.
Back to Smith. 1:27 left in the second quarter. There's the pick. To the paint. Second shot opportunity. Can't get the layup.
Even though he missed it, this is the exact play your offense is designed to produce.
Back to Ross. Passes it to Newton. The feed to Ross. Pass to Stewart. From outside, off the mark. And 36% in the second quarter. They really haven't found their rhythm yet offensively here. To end the cold streak. That one is good. He's only missed one shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
And staying with it. He drained 2 triples in the first quarter. Now gets this one.
40 seconds left in the first half. Nine feet out. A shot off that time. Gone 5 of 12 from the field here in the second. Dishes it to Smith. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Smith's got 5 now.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Free throw line jump shot. That's good on the jump shot. He's got 14.
And that's definitely a shot that he has in his arsenal.
And that's it for the first half of action. What's been a very close game here. Huskies lead by 3. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
Hello, folks. Still a ways off from All-Star Weekend, but let's first check in on who's in the running for this year's three-point contest.
Man, there's some sharpshooters on this list. I would love that opportunity to swat each and every one of their shots.
What if they ran off three screens first?
Wouldn't matter. I'd go right through those. They're lucky to be in this. They have no energy at all on the defensive end. We know slow rotations equal easy buckets. See? See what I just did there?
And they're trying to rely on the offense, Shaq, to save them. Feels like a dangerous approach.
Thanks for joining us. Now let's toss it to Kevin Harlan for the start of the second half.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. The Huskies leading by three. The pass to Newton. Poked away. There's the screen. No good with the layup.
Meeting right at the rim. He typically converts in those situations. Not this time.
That's good again. His seventh basket. 7 for 10 from the floor.
Important points there. Got him on a nice play. Getting the ball inside and right to the bucket.
Smith outside. Beyond the arc. Huskies with the rebound. And about a minute of action so far in the third quarter. Shot clock at 5. He dents the rim with a two-handed slam.
Wow. Not the kind of aggressive defense they need to cut into the lead.
Yeah, you have to protect the rim, Greg, a little better.
Also, if you can't get stops at this point, it really doesn't matter what you do at the offensive end.
Here's Smith, following the bucket by the Huskies. Yep, it counts. 15 points in the game. Over a minute and a half into the third quarter of action. Newton, covered by Smith. From 11 feet away, score that one for him. His 8th field goal, 8 for 11 on a very accurate night. Gone 1 of 3 since starting the second half. Three-pointer. Count that one as his 7th make in 8 attempts. A scorching 88%.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
Pass to Carlemon. Here's Stewart for the three. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Stewart's got the lead up to 7 now for the Huskies.
And still perfect in the second half. 4 straight makes.
Well, we're into the third quarter. Just over 2.5 minutes played. And they come right back with their own three-pointer. He's got 21.
And he's just living out beyond the arc right now. What a weapon to have on the floor.
This is when they need it the most, so they're so close to evening this game up.
Passes it to Newton. Shot clock at 6. The Huskies need to get off a shot here. Shot from the wing. Doesn't go that time.
but only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
And the basket is good. Now just a two-point Husky lead.
I will say this about his shooting stroke. It's pure when he's got it going. Perfect so far this quarter.
Third quarter of basketball here in just a little under 3.5 minutes gone by. To the wing on the left. They set the screen. Out to the right wing. 17-foot shot on the way.
This shot's just, it's not there right now. With this team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
And the pass to Carlemont. Again, the miss by the Husky. Gone 4-7 to get things started here in the second half. Down low for the tie. And it's all evened up. He's got six.
And that tells the tale here today, guys. Throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight finish.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Huskies.
And Coach can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused.
It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
The Huskies making a switch here. Ross has checked in.
And let's check out the stats for Ross, how last month turned out for him. And with a top 20 ranking in field goal percentage, you put the ball in his hands, and he converts at a remarkable rate.
And trying to muscle up shots against him is tough. His body type makes it supremely difficult. Just a dominant rim protector all season. Here's Stewart. He averages about 5 points a game. Inside. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. And why don't we take a chance now to see which teams have been the NBA's highest scoring squads this month.
I just love their offensive flow lately. I mean, this is a dominant team offensively because of that rhythm and pace.
Now the free throw is good, now leading by one. Hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line.
Unfortunate that he missed one, but he still hit a crucial point there to help get his team the lead.
Newton passes to Stewart. They need this one, and the basket good. A bench shot that time. He's got eight. Guys, close one here. No team getting a huge advantage.
Yeah, tooth and nail fight so far, guys. These sides match up really well.
gotten 5 of 8 shots to fall for them in the third quarter. A nice 62% from the field. Now, here is Smith. He's guarded close to the inside on Monday and then on Wednesday.
And you know when you're struggling and in your face heading out on the road, it can be a bit daunting. These guys, though, can see this as an opportunity to kind of really ramp up and gain some confidence.
He misses the free throw. Second free throw, no good. A tight game here in Phoenix. Driving to the basket. Count it.
Unselfish. Moving the ball. Love to see this kind of offense.
Being about 59% from the floor offensively, they've been running without a hitch. This one for three. He doesn't hit that one.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Karaman passes to Newton. He kicks to Ross. 6 on the shot clock. Here's the three. No good on the shot.
Not quite enough defense. That time around, just lucky he was off.
Out to the right wing. A three ball. Buries it from three-point range.
Defensively, you have to tighten up on him or suffer the consequences.
.152 left in the third. Pass to Newton. Six to shoot. Down low. And down it goes. Dunk threw off a wonderful assist.
Those plays can make a difference in a game like this.
Well, you know it's going to fire up, Greg, everybody on that bench.
This is a close-knit group. They feed off one another's energy.
Gone 6 of 10 from the field in the third quarter.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
.124 left to play here in the third. Buries it down low. He has 7. .110 left here in the third quarter. Pass to Ross. Lays it up off the glass. Ross has got 6.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Gone 7 of 11, a lucky field goal percentage here in the third. Jones kicks to Smith. 44 seconds left in the third quarter. He gets it in there.
And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
Pass to Spencer. Ross with it. Shot clock at 6. Here's Karaman. His three-pointers off the mark. Gone 8 of 12 from the field since the beginning of the third. There's the dish to Jones for the lead. And he makes the bucket, gets the whistle, and now a three-point play chance here for him.
Well, you like how aggressive he is making a play at the rim against Lynch.
And let's forget the height disadvantage. He brings the effort, and he brings the energy.
.12 seconds left to play in the third. Now the pass to Ross. Fades and shoots. That one good for 2. 8 points for him. And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. Leading by just 1. And we're just moments away from the start of the fourth quarter. Stay with us. And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. Playing extremely well, 62% on the night to this point. On the wing, Jones. And that one falls for Jones.
And they're doing a better job of working themselves to the line here in the second half.
And so he hits both. Pass to Spencer. Right wing. That's tipped. And he knocks down the first one. and so he's able to get one of two.
Yeah, being down 2 points instead of one thanks to the free throw miss makes getting a stop here absolutely critical.
Basket good.
And coming down the stretch here, both teams still on fire.
Yes, and if you love offense, you're loving this matchup. It's been a highlight reel affair.
And he lobs it up toward the rim. Jones with it. About a minute played here in the fourth quarter. Clock at six. They set the pick from deep. That one's not going to go. Ball surveying the defense. Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. And here is Ross. And it's blocked. Outside, Jones. The tray controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
You know, we talk about it all the time, guys. Those second chance buckets, always the result of that extra effort.
Passes to Spencer to tie it up. Hits the three-point bomb. And this game is tied up now.
And that's right in his wheelhouse, looking to make an impact when it counts.
It's the fourth quarter, and it's a close game. You want to get the ball to someone you can rely on.
Ross against Jones. There's the three. That shot is off. The Huskies have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. They now take the lead. And now a three-point Husky lead.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
To the left wing, to the paint. Ross grabs the board. Ross has got his fifth rebound in this one. Here's Spencer. And the three off target. The ball really well in this game, 58%. They set the pick. It's in, and he's a very efficient 5-for-6 on the game.
Yeah, heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
And we're about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter. Outside ball to the right side. Lets it go from deep. That one, no good. Gone 3-of-7 from the floor in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter. To the middle. And he makes it look easy, dunking it hard with one hand. Guys, what a game. 8 lead changes here.
And don't be surprised if it comes down to the last possession.
And the Huskies call time here.
Start it.
And while we've got a moment, let's send it over to our terrific reporter, David Aldridge. David?
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what Kevin Ollie said to his team. His emphasis was for more effort on the defensive end. He said, we have to do a better job of communicating and helping each other out. They're getting too many easy looks. Let's make it hard on them. Kevin, they're going to have to if they're going to slow down the hot shooting of their opponent.
Thanks so much, David. There's the pass to Newton. Takes the three. Add another basket to his impressive total. It's his ninth against 12 attempts.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Here's Smith. Just five on the clock. Huskies with the rebound.
And you know they wanted that one to go down.
They could have tied it up. That was a huge opportunity they missed.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Huskies will retain possession. A sensational block that definitely deserves another look.
And in a close game, blocks like that are so clutch. And that could be a real difference maker here tonight.
On defense, the visitors. Pass to Carlin. And the Huskies hit again from deep.
12 straight points off of three-pointers, and the D looks shell-shocked.
Gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth. 4 of 9. Throws it up high. And out of bounds as the Huskies gain possession.
Yeah, just not on the same page. Unfortunate. Wasted possession.
The Huskies leading by 5. There's the drive.
Putting consistent pressure on this defense. Just the threat of him out there makes this offense work.
Can't like what he's seeing, trying to get them refocused.
It's so easy to get run over when you lose even a little edge. Look for them to come out much more aggressive.
of bounds as the Huskies gain possession. If they want to, they can milk the clock just a little bit here.
Yeah, that's the best option.
Softly drops in the floater. And it's a 9-point Husky lead.
Man, I'll tell you, when you get your floater game going, it's a tremendous weapon.
To end the run, it's deflected. And it's the Huskies on the break. And he converts the layup. And the Huskies lead by 11.
When you're trying to claw your way back into a game, you cannot allow second chance opportunities.
Especially when you're this far down, you have to make the most of every sequence.
.136 left to play in the final quarter. To the inside, kicks to Smith. 4 on the clock. He had a nice open look right there.
The defense decides to gamble off him, and he cashes in.
The Huskies leading by 8. And he gets the bucket. 27 points for him.
And when the score is as lopsided as it is, and you can see they smell blood in the water, my man is going for the jugular.
1:21 left in the fourth quarter of this one. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
You know, I love how he absorbs the foul and still had a chance to knock that one down.
And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Huskies.
They are making it rain from the three-point land right now, and the coaching staff continues to encourage them to let it fly.
And also, they took advantage of their quickness, got inside and blew through the open lanes. Great job of attacking the paint.
And no good as the first free throw missing for him. We'll see if he can nail the second. And the second of 2 is good. That brings them within single digits.
No way he is happy with himself right now. He knows he has to knock every shot down at this point in the game.
Passes it to Newton, launches a 3, and the Huskies hit again from deep.
And these are the types of games where one team clearly has the edge. Tonight, it will be a win by a large margin for the Huskies.
And they had to battle for this win. There were times when it looked like it was maybe slipping away a bit, but they never let that happen, which I thought was a real credit to them.
And that's a product of their mental toughness. Anytime the flow of the game turned against them, instead of caving, they just dialed it up a notch and were able to pull away.
And a milestone win for the season. This will push their victory total to 20 wins even.
And with the win approaching, they'll take the first game here of 2 that they'll play against this team. Nice to get that first one out of the way and set the tone.
There's 21 seconds left in the fourth quarter. They get the rebound, goes back up, and foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. First one falls for him. That one misses. So the Huskies win it.
Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
And that'll do it, folks. Now for Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports. As we end with the New Balance Player of the Game.